What is happening, guys? Reflex here, and today I'm going to be showing you the best audio settings for your Astro A40 TRs. Now, this is for Modern Warfare. You saw the first video on the best in-game settings. I'm going to give you a quick recap on what I would recommend having your settings as in-game before we go over to the Astro A40 settings in the software on the computer. So I'm going to just show you these top four because these are the like most important in my opinion. I keep my audio mix on boost high just because that is the best audio setting I have found in the game so far when it comes to hearing footsteps and hearing movement of the opponents and everything. With the way the audio is, it's so loud already and everything is so loud and crunchy and you hear so many people all over the place. This is just the best setting for it as of right now. Obviously, I keep my master volume at 100 just because why not? That's just your global volume and you want to be able to hear everything. This is also really key. I keep my music pretty much off just because music for me, I can't speak for everybody, but for me, music is a little distracting. I don't really like it. And if I'm in the middle of an S&D round and I hear, you know, some weird music starts playing, I just kind of get annoyed and it kind of distracts me from hearing something that I need to hear. Dialogue, this is like the voiceover volume, and I keep that kind of like just above low, so it's just not too loud, and I don't know, that's just a personal preference. And then I keep my in-game effects obviously all the way up. These two should be left at default just because they're so important. But yeah, these are just the in-game Modern Warfare audio settings. Now let's go ahead and jump over to the computer for the Astro A40 software in the command center, and I'll show you what I use to be successful in Modern Warfare. All right, so we're over here in the Astro Command Center, and this is what the software looks like when you first download it and get it up and running. Now, if you don't know how to do this yet, I mean, this is pretty self-explanatory, but I know some people are gonna ask some questions about this, so I'll just go ahead and explain. You obviously have to plug the USB cable from your Astros into your PC so your PC can read from the software to the mix amp. That should be common sense, but I know for a lot of people it might not be. So you have to plug this into your PC, switch your mix amp to PC mode by holding the power button for I think it's like 2 seconds, and then it'll switch to PC mode, and then your software will read that it is connected to a mix amp. So here we are in the mix amp software, and it's pretty simple. It's not, I mean, it can be very complicated, but I'm just going to show you what I use in Modern Warfare. And personally, I play on this mode right here, tournament mode, and then I go over to the settings, and this bar right here, drop it all the way down to -7. This adjusts the treble and the way the audio works in Modern Warfare. If footsteps are going down, it's kind of like a little crunch. It's a bit of a crunch, and if you drop that down to -7, it's even crunchier, and I can just hear it from the other side of the map if you drop that all the way down to -7. And then we have the second setting right here. I bring that up to -4, and these last three I leave at default. This is pretty simple. This is just what I play on. I've played on a couple different ones in other games, but in Modern Warfare, this is what's worked for me. You can play on balanced, or I mean, it comes down to personal preference, but for me, this is what's working with sound whoring, which is so important in Modern Warfare. But natural bass for me is just too much bass. The next best one I would recommend is just like the default Astro setting. It's just, it's good, but for me, tournament mode is the way to go. And then you just click sync to device and then save, and then that will save these settings in your, into your mix amp, and then it'll sync it up, and then you can then plug your USB port back into your PlayStation and go from there. You can also adjust your microphone levels. I leave these on default just because they're fine the way they are, and you can adjust these if you want to. But yeah, that's pretty much all that there is. This is what I would recommend for literally hearing people across the map and inside buildings. I can't tell you how many rounds I've won because of my headset. It's just so key in this game. But guys, hope this was helpful. Try these out if you want to. Drop a like for me. Hit that sub button. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter if you haven't yet to stay updated with live streams, new videos, and just stay connected with me, guys. Anyway, I appreciate it so much. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you later. Peace.